Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please, to open our show, please welcome your hostess and MC for the evening, the one and only, the mistress of mayhem, Hurricane Summer.
I worry about the future. I think we all worry about the future. And now they're telling us that we may have to work up into our 70s. This really sucks. That there's probably not going to be any Social Security left for us. And I don't know about anybody else here. How many people are with me that don't want to work now? And I have this nightmare, you know, that I'm going to end up 75, 80 years old, some old lounge comedian in Vegas. I wouldn't even be good enough for Vegas. I'll be in fucking Laughlin. You know, I got that lipstick drawn way up here. Got that pink, blue, green eyeshadow on, look like a rainbow trout. Them big Tammy Baker eyelashes on. Two little dots for rouge. Little osteoporosis. Oh, and of course I'm drinking again. Oh, and I talk like this, cause I've been smoking for 40 years. So it's Saturday night at the Edgewater Hotel. And of course by then, I would have changed my name to something more exotic like Miss Pepper.
were born on this beautiful island off the coast of Greece called the Isle of Clitoris. Yeah. And there's no men there. Because they can't find them. For no direction. You be driving with a man, you got a map, you got a compass, you got a fucking Indian in the back seat of that car. They always say the same thing. Well, I don't know where we are, but we're making good time, damn it. So if women come from the Isle of Clitoris, then that would mean that men come from the Isle of Penis, kind of dangling off over here in the Dead Sea. In fact, some of the women from the Isle of Clitoris swam over to the Isle of Penis, swam back because it wasn't as big as they heard it was. We've all been on that little boat ride, haven't we, girl?
Well.
Then I get asked a lot. But why is it so much easier for a man to have an orgasm than a woman? It's their friend. It's their pal. It's their little buddy. He's not gonna let them down in a crisis. So the secret is, girls, you've got to name your clitoris. Maybe if we name it, it'll fucking come if we call it. But you got to name it something that men want to get close to. So I call mine Joe Montana. Sometimes he fumbles and I have to run it in myself, but hey. So I have a new insignificant other in my life. He's so old, I thought the condoms in his wallet were pictures of his kids. He's an idiot. He can't get it up. Trust me, girls, you haven't lived until you've seen a soft on. That's where it's hard from the bottom to the middle. And the top of it's like the fucking weevil people. Where are you gonna put that? Freezer. The other day, my old man goes to the Social Security office to pick up his check. Forgot his ID. Opened up his shirt, showed him the gray hair on his chest, got the check, brought it home. I said, why didn't you pull down your pants and get disability? You know, men are always saying, what do women want? What in the hell do women want? Well, I finally really figured that out. It is romance. Be romantic. I told my old man the other night, I said, listen, fucker. On the boob. He said, you know, honey, this could give milk. We get rid of that cow. Then he reached over, grabbed me on the bottom. He said, you know, honey, this give eggs. We get rid of that chicken. So I grabbed his dick. You know, honey, if this could get hard, we could get rid of your brother.
as she came into the place of New York than in jail. There was something different about this girl. The way she moved, her hair, her face, her lines, divinity in motion.
Number 4, Michael B. They lost my luggage, every last bit. of my New York shopping spree. Don't. Don't ever fly Delta, US Airways, America West. I'm gonna sue them bitches lovely, honey. My two Gustavo gowns are in there.
Are you guys having a good time? Hi, judges. I can't see you. I see a bright orange and a beige shirt. And everything else is black. No pun intended. Well, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the pageant. It's supposed to be really, really entertaining, I heard. And I'll be back later. I gotta catch my breath, get something to eat, I'm hungry. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Miss Entertainment of the Year 2005, Angelique Ali. Now please welcome the night who the man is all about. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2005, Rayshon Montreal. We'll be right back.
that is most unique to
Hello, hello, hello. Maestro, if you would please, music for the contestants. Ladies and gentlemen, the creative evening wear, please welcome contestant number one, William Terrell Benion. William is from St. Louis, Missouri. He's representing Mr. Missouri EOR. He's sponsored by Victoria Parker, Versailles, Troy Constantino, The Rockers Club, Antoine Steele, Mr. Black Universe, Desiree Desmoray, Miss Continental Plus 2006. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, in creative evening wear, contestant number one, William Terrell Benion. William, at this time, the judges will ask the question and he will answer.
How are you doing, Ed?
Hi, William, how are you?
Doing wonderful.
It's Asia.
Hi, Asia.
I'm going to ask you a question twice and then I'm going to give you the opportunity to answer, okay?
Okay.
You stated that you've been an entertainer for 20 years and that now you are ready to take on the responsibilities of becoming Mr. Entertainer of the Year. Through your 20 years, what steps have you taken to ready yourself, and what steps would you advise to a young man on his way up not to take? Once again, you stated that you've been an entertainer for 20 years and that now you are ready to take on the responsibilities of becoming Mr. EOY. Through your 20 years, what steps have you taken to ready yourself, and what steps would you advise to a young man on his way up not to take? Good luck.
Thank you, Asia. Before I ask the question, I just would like to thank all of you for coming out. Give this wonderful establishment, Eddie and George, a round of applause because they have done an excellent job. I also would like to thank my family who is present. Wherever you are, I can't see you, but just please stand. My mom, a lady who's been in my life since high school with her daughters, we've come close, my play mom, and also my aunt, they're here in attendance. And I just am proud to have a supportive family that will come all the way from St. Louis and be here with us tonight. Thank you so much. And to answer the question, what steps did I take in my many years of experience? To answer the first part, the first step was just to listen. Because I know I didn't know everything starting out, and I still listen. So I listen, listen, and listen. And after I listen, I learn. Those are the steps I take. And then advice I would give those that are coming up? What steps should they take? What steps they shouldn't take? Well, don't think that you know it all, because when you know it all, you don't give yourself room to improve or grow. So that's what I would say. And thank you very much. I'm William Terrell Benion, contestant number one.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, William Terrell Benion. Please welcome contestant number two, Savio Simpson. Savion is from St. Louis, Missouri. She's representing Michigan Derby City in the game of New York. He's sponsored by The Connection, House of Simpson, Camino Simpson, Porsche Vintage Debris, Crystal Light, Attitude's Nightclub, and a host of family, friends, and children. Gentlemen and judges, contestant number two, Savion Simpson.
Hi, Savion. How are you doing?
Fine. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. Thank you. I'm going to ask you a question twice and then give you the opportunity to answer. After being first runner-up last year, you stated that you have listened, lived, and learned. What is the most important thing you feel you needed to change in this year's contest? Once again, after being first alternate last year, you stated that you have listened, lived, and learned. What is the most important thing you feel you needed to change for this year's competition? Good luck.
Thank you. In response to the question, after being first runner-up, I did listen, live, and learn. I listened to the individuals who've gone before me, the role models, the former Mr. EO Wise, because they've been in my shoes and they know what it takes to win. Also, I've listened to you, the audience, on what I needed to do or what I didn't need to do. But one thing that I changed and I listened to that all you should listen to when you have a dream, listen to your heart. If you listen to your heart, it will direct you in the right path. It has directed me with the right package to be Mr. National Entertainer of the Year. I listen to my heart. Also, while listening to my heart, I live every day. For 365 days after pageant, I live my life to the fullest, doing what it took to make me a better person and a better entertainer. But in one thing that I did to prepare in living, I worked and prepared. I got ready physically and mentally and prepared myself. In learning, I learned not to make the same mistakes that I've made in the past. I corrected them, I put it all together. So through living and listening, I've learned that I can be Mr. National Entertainer of the Year. Thank you.
Contestant number two, Savion Simpson. Please welcome contestant number three, Skylar Stiles. From Cleveland, Ohio. He is the Mr. Ohio Entertainer of the Year. He's sponsored by John Curacao, Bounce Nightclub, Adam Street, Kimberbelt Nightclub, and a host of family and friends. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number three, Skylar Stiles.
Hi, Skylar. How are you doing tonight?
I am awesome. Which side are you on?
I'm kind of here at the judges' table.
Oh, I see you.
I'm going to ask your question twice, then give you the opportunity to answer, okay?
Sure.
You stated that you've been performing for 7 years and competing for the past 4. What accomplishments in those 3 years has given you the confidence to be here tonight? Once again, you've been performing for 7 years and competing for 4. What accomplishments in those 3 years has given you the confidence to be here tonight? Good luck.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, for your consideration and approval, my name is Skylar Styles, contestant number 3. I'm having an awesome time here. In response to the question, what has given me confidence to compete at a national, this is my first national pageant, and I would definitely have to say, last August, I was crowned Mr. Ohio All-Star, which is the biggest and most well-known and most prestigious, I guess you can say, male pageant in Ohio. I was crowned, at the time there was only 16 prelims. By the end of my reign, as soon as I get back, I step down, I now have 26. I think that's a lot of confidence, especially being a first-time state taught. That was my first state title, and I'm really proud, and that, I mean, I just learned so much just from being a state title holder that one time. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, in response to the question, inform aware, my name is Skylar Styles, your contestant, number 3. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 3, Skylar Styles. Would you please welcome our next contestant, contestant number 4, Michael B. Is from Charleston, West Virginia. He's representing Mr. Mountain State Regional in the beginning of the year. He's sponsored by Light Productions, Traps Nightclub in Charleston, West Virginia, Solomon Productions, Roger Leg, The Sisters Dancing, Friends of Louisville, and a host of great friends of West Virginia. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 4, Michael B.
Thank you.
Hi, Michael. How are you?
Fabulous. How about yourself, Asia?
Thank you. I'm doing wonderful. I'm going to read you your questions twice and then give you the opportunity to answer. You stated that you've been the show director for Traps Nightclub in West Virginia. As a show director, what do you feel a Mr. Entertainer should hold most important as he reigns, and why? Once again, you stated that you are the show director for Traps Nightclub in West Virginia. As a show director, what do you feel a Mr. Entertainer of the Year should hold most important as he reigns, and why? Good luck.
Well, Miss Asia, I myself feel it is very important as Entertainer of the Year to stress entertainment. As I said in my presentation last evening, that entertainment is a universal language. It transcends all discrimination, intolerance, any bigotry or hate. So you get out there and you show them that you have love in your heart for anyone and everyone, and you will entertain them the best you can. So that makes you Entertainer of the Year. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 4, Michael B. Please welcome our next contestant, contestant number 5, Michael J. Valentine.
is from Shepherdsville, Kentucky. He is sponsored by the production of Louisville and the host of Many Friends. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 5, Michael J. Valentine.
Hi, Michael, how are you doing?
I'm good, Asia, how are you?
I'm wonderful, thank you. I'm going to ask you a question twice and then give you the opportunity to answer.
Yes.
In your bio, you stated that you are a painter, an erotic dancer, a male lead for La Voix La Femme, and a cheerleader for the University of Louisville National Champions Cheerleading Squad. Of these 4, which one brings you the most joy and why? Once again, in your bio you stated you are a painter, an erotic dancer, a male lead for La Voix La Femme, and a cheerleader for the University of Louisville National Champions Cheerleading Squad. Of these 4, which one brings you the most joy and why? Good luck.
Well, I love performing, so I would have to pick cheerleading because I love the feeling of getting the crowd hyped up and being in front of all those lights and everybody watching me doing what I do and what I love to do best. And, and I just like being out in front of everybody, just doing what I love the most. And before I go, I would actually like to give this rose to someone who's very special to me, who came to see me tonight, and I love her very much, and it's my mother.
All right, Mama.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 5, Michael J. Valentine. Please welcome contestant number 6, DC Legend. DC is from Woodridge, Virginia.
All right.
He's representing Indiana in the Trainer of the Year. He is sponsored by Sean Batten, Greg Chenault, Rachel Montrese, and Gina Roman. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, contestant number 6, DC Legend.
Good evening, how are you?
I'm wonderful, thank
good.
You.
Thank you.
I'm going to answer your question. I'm going to ask you your question twice, then give you the opportunity to answer. In your bio, you said that you are inspired by the simple things in life. Give us an example of something simple that inspired you for competing tonight. In your bio, you stated that you are inspired by the simple things in life. Give us an example of something simple that inspired you to be here competing tonight. Good luck.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished panels of judges. For your consideration, I am contestant number 6, DC Legend. And in my bio, I did state that I am inspired by the simple things in life. And actually, today, I came down here with my dresser. Her name is Gina Bowman. And we had a little issue with my talent earlier because I wasn't feeling all that great enough to sing the song that I wanted to sing. And she was like, well, what do you feel in your heart? What do you feel in your heart? And I was like, well, I said, I feel a lot of things in my heart every day. And she was like, okay, well, what about this? I put it in a CD, and it was one of my favorite songs that I, you know, that I love to sing. I love it, the words. And it just makes me smile. And so that inspired me to be here in competing today. And it was something simple, as easy as putting in a CD. And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for your consideration. Again, your contestant number 6, E.T. Lutz.
Contestant 2005, Rishon Montrez.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Entertainer of the Year, give it up. Good job. My treat. Sorry about that, kid. It's dark as hell and I almost fell down the stairs. Pardon me. Hold on, let big bitch through. Now I want you all to scream and yell for these kids, because the more that you carry on, the harder they're gonna work. So you want us a good show, don't you? And the more that you give them improvement, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, representing Mr. Missouri EOI. If you will, give it up for William, Terrell, Benion, I'm sorry, William Terrell Benion, contestant number one. Give it up for him. We'll be right back.
gentlemen, please welcome. He is representing Mr. Derby City EOI. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. This is Savion Simpson, contestant number two. Mr. Ohio EOI. Please give it up, ladies and gentlemen. This is Skylar Styles, contestant number 3.
Thank you.
White Scout Pitch Hotel or. Please give it up for contestant number four. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Michael B., contestant number four.
Now, what would a scarecrow do with money?
Save it up to buy me a brain.
That's silly. You can't buy brains.
You can't?
No.
Well, how about that?
What do you want brains for? Isn't it any fun being a scarecrow?
Well, I thought it would be, but after 15 minutes of this here ball, I knew I wasn't going any place.
Scarecrow, how'd you like to get down off that pole?
I thought you'd never ask. Just pull that button down there. Sure feels good to stand on my own 2 feet again. Thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. DC Legend.
To the swim marriage category.
If you would please put your hands together, maestro a little music please, and we'll bring out our contestants for the swimwear competition. The more noise you make, the more they model the wares you want to see. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, please welcome contestant number one, William Terrell of Benion. William is Mr. Missouri, you know what? He's sponsored by Victoria Parker, Versace, Troy Constantino, The Rockers Club, Antoine Steele, Mr. Black Universe, Desiree DeMornay, Miss Continental Plus 2006. Contestant number one in swimwear competition, William Terrell Benion. Please welcome contestant number two, Sadiam Simpson. Is representing Mr. Derby City, Iowa. He is sponsored by Connections, House of Simpson, Camille Simpson, Portia B. Dupree, Crystal Light, Attitudes Nightclub, and a host of family and friends and children. Judges, contestant number two, Sadiam Simpson. Please welcome contestant number three, Skylar Stiles. Skylar is representing Mr. Ohio, Iowa. He is represented by the promoter, Mr. John Dercio, Bounce Nightclub, Adams Street, Vanderbilt Nightclub, and a host of family and friends. Contestant number four, Michael B. Michael is from Charleston, West Virginia. He's representing Mr. Mountain State Regional Entertainer of the Year. He is sponsored by Lock Productions, Tracks Night Club in Charleston, West Virginia, Solmar Productions, Roger Legg, The Sisters Dancers, Friends of Louisville, and a host of great friends of West Virginia. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, this is contestant number four, Michael B. Contestant number five, Mr. Michael J. Valentine.
Michael is from Shepherdsville, Kentucky. He is sponsored by The Connection and a host of many friends and family. Gentlemen and judges, contestant number 5 of Michael J. Valentine. And our final contestant in swimwear competition, please welcome contestant number 6, DC Legend. From Woodbridge, Virginia. He's representing Indiana Entertainer of the Year. He is sponsored by Ray Sean Montreat, Sean Bat, Greg Chenault, and Gina Bowman. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 6 in swimwear competition, DC Legend. This concludes our competitions for this evening. And now while the judges tabulate the scores, if you would please. Oh, there she is. She's finished shaving. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, Hurricane Summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eddie D, give it up for him. Or Ed Lewis, I'm sorry.
Welcome to the stage. You can go ahead and kill the lights, and I'm going to go over here and give this to her.
I need a
you
shot.
You can go ahead and kill the... Oh, we're going to do the shot?
No, I need a shot.
Let's do a shot, baby. A shot.
Disable? All right, ladies and gentlemen, before I go...
Kalani needs a shot.
Those of you with small concentrations, you might want to turn away.
Hurricane.
Here's to the vampirous named Sable, whose period was most unstable. So every full moon, she took out a spoon and then she drank herself under the table. Yeah, like you won't be telling that tomorrow.
We told it last week.
Yeah. If you will, give it up for the live vocal talents, the body of the beauty, Miss National Entertainer of the Year, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Miss Angelique Ali.
Thank you.
flow, but you will need help trying to stay my bounce slow. Go, what's the difference? One, you take a game by the other, you slip in it. Go, try to convict them. It's a no, but my girl keep the scales tipping like foe. Trolls, like I'm from the H-O-U-S-T-O. In, blow, win. Social card with him, is he the best ever? That's the argument, man. I don't make the list, don't be mad at me. I just make the hits like a factory. I'm just one to one, nothing after me. No deja vu, just he in my
mind.
Ali, at National Entertainment of the Year, who has a contract, a recording contract. She will be releasing her record, unlike her other records in her filed way. And she is going to be releasing her record. So, ladies and gentlemen, one of our owners, not our owners, but owners of the club at National Entertainment of the Year, just had a birthday. So, Angelique, please prove to be skeptics. Yes, you fucker, sit in the front row with your hands in your hand.
It's also Rashawn's birthday.
Oh, it is Rashawn.
My husband's birthday. It's tonight. Tonight's his birthday. Isn't that beautiful?
Oh my God, I did not know. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. National Entertainment of the Year's birthday is tonight. I didn't know that. Nobody fucking told me anything. Ladies and gentlemen, in honor of Mr. Stenson, any of you who might have a birthday, and of course, our Mr. Entertainment of the Year. Ladies and gentlemen, Angelique Ali to tell all of you, fuck you, that is my voice.
That is so many words.
It was an acapella.
Here we go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to
You can look it up. It's called Phenomenon Unexplained at myspace.com. The song is called Seduces Me. Remix comes out at the end of the fall. So, holla.
Get some intel.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is Miss Entertainer of the Year.
and Jimmy Golly, give it up for her. In August,
she will be giving up her title, so make sure that you have tickets. We've given you information. The finals will be by ticket only. You must go in online, etc., etc., etc. Ladies and gentlemen, please.
First, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out and helping me celebrate a wonderful year and my birthday. Somehow 14 months doesn't seem long enough. Ever since I was little, I can remember wanting to be a Michael Jackson on stage. I was so excited to be pronounced Mr. EOY 2005. Tonight, I not only celebrate a successful year, but I also celebrate my 25th birthday. Over the years, there have been a lot of people there to guide me on my path. First, I would like to thank Mocha Montrese.
Mocha!
Thank you for all your support, your tough love, and your knowledge. Now it's your turn. To Pretty Boys Inc., for the many years of dancing and letting me have drag droppings on the floor, thanks for helping me and making my dreams come true. To LaWanda Jackson, a true friend that I met only because of EOY. I am so grateful for our meeting. So many doors you have opened for me. Thank you for being you, a star. Anthony Watson, for your love and dedication to the EOY system and my career, I personally thank you. Shining Star Productions, a special thanks goes out to you for your marketing and advice during the last year. It was greatly appreciated and will never be forgotten. Lastly, I want to thank my mother, who could not be here tonight, for standing by me and sharing in my dream. DJ, if you're ready.
Mr. Entertainer of the Year, Rashawn Montrese.
Take all of me.
for Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2005, Rashawn Montrese. Happy birthday.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Rashawn, where are you? Yeah, I got it.
Told me to hurry up. I was missing.
If I can get the spotlight, please. I'm over here. Thank you. This is our fifth year of Entertainer of the Year. Tonight we'll be awarding someone with that title. Tonight we'll also start a new tradition of awarding Promoter of the Year to an individual who exhibits tireless dedication to the EOY system, specifically Mr. EOY. Tonight we want to present that award to none other than the Missouri Entertainer of the Year promoter, Anthony Watson. The plaque reads, please accept this small token of our gratitude for your dedication to the contest. Congratulations on a successful competition year.
Contestants back out here again. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, William Benion. Benion. Contestant number two, Savio Simpson. Contestant number three, Skylar Style. Contestant number four, Michael B. Contestant number five, Michael J. Valentine. Contestant number six, DC Ledger. And ladies and gentlemen, your hostess and MC for this evening, the mistress of Mayhem Hurricane Summer. And a big thank you to our Entertainer of the Year 2005, Angelique Ali. And of course, another round of applause for Mr. Entertainer of the Year, Rashawn Montrese. And somewhere is the Director of Entertainer of the Year, George Stinson.
Somewhere.
And the judges have given me their decisions. Ladies and gentlemen, the second alternate for Entertainer of the Year, Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2006, goes to contestant number three, Skylar Styles. For Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2006 is contestant number five, Michael J. Valentine. And now it's with great pleasure I announce the judge's decision for Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2006. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, William Hickman.
I am one.
since this year for the Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2006 contest. Our second alternate, Skylar Styles. Our first alternate, Michael J. Valentine. And our new Mr. Entertainer of the Year 2006, William Davis.
Get out your cameras, ladies and gentlemen, it is photo time. If we may have our current, our reigning, and our former. Have you had a good time? Don't forget, videos are available at kalaniproductions.
Don't worry, Hurricane Candy photoshopped out of that picture.